Most of the electronic gadgets or the electronic system that we are using are made up of silicon. But in the last one decade, a research on other wide bandgap semiconductor materials like a gallium nitride and the silicon carbide has accelerated. And in fact, now many commercial products are also available in the market. For example, gallium nitride based fast chargers are readily available for the smartphones and the tablets. And in the form of integrated circuits, these gallium nitride transistors are also used in many power electronic applications. Moreover, it will also play a crucial role in the upcoming 5G networks. So in this video, let us understand what is so special about this gallium nitride and why in some application it is preferred over the silicon. So this gallium nitride is a wide bandgap semiconductor material. In solids, the bandgap is the difference between the valence band and the conduction band. In case of this gallium nitride, this bandgap is 3.4 eV, while in case of the silicon it is 1.1 eV. So in case of this wide bandgap semiconductor materials, the bandgap is more than the usual semiconductors like the silicon and the germanium. And this table shows the bandgap of the different semiconductor materials. So because of this wide bandgap, the gallium nitride is already used in the photonics since a long time, like for the generating the blue LEDs and the blue laser diodes. And in fact, these LEDs you will also find in the Blu-ray DVD players. And today, because of this gallium nitride blue LEDs, it is also possible to generate the white LEDs which is available commercially. But because of its other useful properties, it is also used in the power electronics as well as at the microwave frequencies. So let us understand that. Now, because of the wide bandgap, this gallium nitride works more reliably than the silicon at the high voltages and the high temperatures. Moreover, compared to silicon, this gallium nitride has a higher electron mobility. The electron mobility shows how quickly an electron can move through a metal or semiconductor when it is pushed through the electric field. So this gallium nitride based transistors have a low on resistance. That means when the transistor is used as a switch, then in the on condition, it offers a low resistance than the silicon, which means it is more efficient than the silicon transistors. Moreover, the breakdown threshold of this gallium nitride is almost 10 times more than the silicon. That means for the same operating voltage, the gallium nitride transistor requires a less space than the silicon transistor. Or for the same size, it can be operated at higher voltages more reliably. And if I put all together, then for the given operating voltage and the current, the gallium nitride based transistors requires a less space and it is more efficient than the silicon counterpart. Moreover, the high frequency dielectric constant of this gallium nitride is almost half than the silicon. That means this gallium nitride based transistors has a lower gate capacitance than the other intrinsic capacitance, and because of which it can work at the high frequencies. And that is why it is used as an amplifier in many equipments at the microwave and the millimeter wave frequencies. Not only this gallium nitride works at high frequencies, but it also works more efficiently and consumes less power. And that is the reason all 5G base stations will use these gallium nitride based power amplifiers. In high power applications, even at the high voltages, these gallium nitride based transistors can operate at high switching speeds. And because of the high switching speed, in the power electronics, it reduces the overall size of the switching type converter. For example, a modern fast chargers uses the very efficient active clamp flyback converter. And in this type of converters, the MOSFET is used as a switch. But using the gallium nitride transistors as a switch, the switching frequency can be further increased. And it reduces the size of the passive components like the capacitors and the inductors. And this reduces the overall size of the charger. And since the gallium nitride based devices are more efficient, it also generates the less heat compared to the silicon chargers. So this high efficiency, good reliability and the smaller device footprint make these gallium nitride devices an excellent alternative to silicon in many applications. For example, in electric vehicles, using this gallium nitride and the silicon carbide based electronic components, the efficiency of this electric vehicle can be increased. Moreover, in the future, the DC to DC converters in the data centers and the servers can be replaced with the gallium nitride based devices, which not only consumes a less power, but it also generates the less heat. So the question is this gallium nitride a future of electronics, and can they replace all our silicon devices in future with this gallium nitride based devices? Well, the short answer is no. The reason is, the fabrication of the silicon wafers and the manufacturing of these silicon based devices is in quite mature phase, and it is an effort of the years of research. Moreover, this silicon is much cheaper than the other materials, and it is also easily available. Speaking about the gallium nitride, there is a lot of difficulty in manufacturing the gallium nitride substrate. 20 years back, the dislocations or the defects in this gallium nitride substrate were 1 billion per centimeter square. But because of the new manufacturing techniques, the number of defects has lowered to certain extent. But the cost to produce such wafer is far more than the silicon. So currently, in majority of the gallium nitride devices, a silicon or the silicon carbide is used as a substrate. The advantage of the silicon substrate is that most of the existing silicon manufacturing facilities can be used for the gallium nitride. But in some high frequency applications, this silicon carbide is used as a substrate. So if I summarize, then this gallium nitride won't replace the silicon in the near future. But in power electronics and in the microwave frequency applications, it will definitely be used more and more over the silicon in the coming years. So that's it for this video. And I hope in this video, you understood what is gallium nitride and how is it different from silicon in the many aspects. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.